everyone, it's Nancy again, and apparently I don't know the meaning of the word organized as well as I don't know the meaning of the word moderation. But let's chat, shall we? So it's been a couple of weeks since my last video, and my last one was the Year of Whips, my Year of Whips lineup. And I was going to watch it. So I don't know where anything is. So I could show you what I have done in with some of those. I do have one of them. But I want to explain something. Cross-stitching is supposed to be fun. Cross-stitching is supposed to be my meditation and my relaxation, and it hasn't felt that way recently. Not that I don't have a stitchy bug, I wanted to stitch, it's just that the projects that I've been working on, they haven't really thrilled me. While we were in France, and I honestly don't even know if I uploaded the video about France, because I can't, my computer has some kind of problem where if I have the internet open at the same time that I have my word processing program open, they both freeze. It's like my computer has to like think, oh, you want me to close a window. Okay, well that's gonna take me like another 30 seconds in order to do that. And I couldn't open up YouTube and see what I had uploaded. And I wonder why I don't have very many subscribers, because I have very, oh my, videos are terrible. Anyhow, when I was in France, I was working on the Madonna and Child, and I was really enjoying it. And I got home, and it had been about a week and a half that I'd been working on that project straight, and it wasn't fun anymore. It had got to a point where it wasn't fun. And a few months ago, probably back in June or something, I had made a spreadsheet of the entire year to come and kind of listed all the sales that Stitch Mania was having, and go through and figure out what I was going to work on. And I had all of these things. And for the Year of Whips, I had put all of my whips in, and I kind of gave myself 2 days to work on them, as well as the Stitch Mania sales and just like all the sales that were going on. And I found that I was working sometimes 3 projects a day. And eventually it got to a place where, especially with the Year of Whips, when I started on that one, I was only giving myself 2 days per project, and a couple of the projects I was like, I really wish I could stitch longer on these. This is fun. But I was trying to stick to my schedule so that I could go through everything, and finally I just threw it all out the window. I just decided to stitch on what I want to stitch whatever happens to be fun at the time. Still with the idea that I'd like to finish things, but I'm going to still try to participate in some of the sales, but stitching is supposed to be fun. And it wasn't fun. It was like, oh no, I have to like put this one down and pick up something else now because it's a different day, or because I didn't work on that yet today, or whatever. And that wasn't making me happy. So I'm going to show you the one. I had another project. Maybe this was the first one that I worked on for the Year of Whips, the Blue Madonna. And I'll insert a picture of it here, what it looked like before I started the Year of Whips challenge. And here's where I am now. I worked a little more on her veil. It's kind of hard to tell because a lot of the stitches were just fill in. My dog's, she's snoring over there. And I started doing some of her face. I think I'm going to go back and work on that one some more. So that's what I've been working on for that. In other news, and I worked on bits and pieces of just a bunch of different things. I worked on oh, I started. Oh, I worked a little bit on Ariel. I worked a little bit on Ariel. I think I might have posted pictures in Stitch Mania about her. I'll put a picture of what she's supposed to look like here. And this is all I have done on her. It's the top. But she was fun, and that she was the one that made me decide to stop trying to go strictly by my personal setup of rotation because things weren't, like I said, she was fun and I wanted to stitch on her some more. That's not it. Oh, some other things that I worked on. I downloaded the Alice in Wonderland, the Alice in Wonderland sampler from Play-Doh Squirrel on Etsy, and I'll put a picture of what it's supposed to look like here. And this is where I am. This is 14 count Ada. It's called Pretty in Pink, and I got it off Stash Unload. I don't remember where it came from. But it was pink, and I didn't know what I was going to do with it when I got it, but it was pink, and so I got it because it's pink. What else did I work on? I have a couple of those are haul. I will put those aside so I will show you. I think I have a lot more haul, but it's not easily accessible. Oh yeah, there's more haul in here. Close over here. I worked on, oh, that's just a piece of fabric. Let's see, what else do I have? Anything interesting? Anything to show you that you might be interested in? No. I also got the Once Upon a Time sampler from Frosted Pumpkin, and I did like four stitches on it. I'm not even going to show it because I just did four stitches. I was doing that someplace where I didn't have all my floss with me, and to that end, I have bought those double-sided. I don't have they're on the other side of the room. The double-sided keeper things that you can get at Joann's or Michael's. I got two of them at Michael's with a. They were 50% off. All craft storage was 50% off, but I had a coupon as a Michael's Insider or whatever they're called for 20% off the craft storage on top of that. So they're $19.99 at Michael's. I think they're only like $14.99 at Joann's. But they were $19.99 at Michael's, so half off was $9.99, and then another 20%. So I only paid $7.99 for two of them. Well, each for two of them. But I still have more floss. So I went to Joann's and I got a third one that's not full, but I have floss that are still in skeins and in places that are there in bags for projects. I had a frustration while I was a while back. I think I told you that I started a full size. It's a Heyd mermaid. It's just called mermaid. I will put a picture here. And I was doing it one over one on 28 count, maybe it was, maybe 25. I can't remember. And it was driving me crazy. It wasn't fun. I would stitch like 300 stitches and it was this big. And I was I didn't want to pick it up. So while I was at Joann's, I bought one of those 48 by 60 big pieces that are $21.99, and I have a 60% off coupon, so I bought that. And I cut it down to stitch it for my husband because the mermaid is for him. And I measured it all out. I cut the right size. I was very excited, and I started stitching. And I got, this is the upper right corner, except that I'm stitching it the wrong way. It's supposed to go like this, so the upper right corner would be here, and I started stitching it this way. So I got about 220 odd stitches in and got ticked off again. So I'm putting mermaid in timeout until I get back to her. I worked on, I believe this is the Once Upon a Time sampler. Oh no. This is the Once Upon a Time sampler. I believe this is the Once Upon a Time. No, this is Christmas on Gingerbread Lane by Frosted Pumpkin. I got that one too. And this is how far I am. It's just a door. Actually, that was upside down. This is the door. That's all I got on that one. Oh, I'll put a picture here. But I only got to the door on that. Okay, so those are some pieces that I have been working on. Just like I said, bits and pieces of things. I guess that's all that's in this basket. Some bits and pieces of just charts that I picked up that were fun to stitch on. I want to show, this is a whip, it's not a whip, it was a finish at one time. This was one of my first cross stitches. It's a Precious Moments. It says, I believe in miracles. And it's on a really small piece of fabric in 1984. My father had a kidney transplant. He'd been on dialysis for 3.5 years, and he finally got a transplant. And he got his transplant, must have been August or September he got his transplant. And we were very happy. It was a very, very big deal, because like I said, he'd been waiting 3.5 years for a transplant. And so I stitched the I Believe in Miracles, because the doctor told us that it was a cadaver donor, and he said that the kidney matched my dad so well that he could have spit in the wound and it still probably would have worked. And Dad was very happy. We were all very happy, and I stitched this was going to be a present for him for Christmas. But he died in November. He had a massive heart attack because he'd been on dialysis for 3.5 years and his body was just tired, and he never saw it. I made it into a pillow and gave it to my mom for Christmas. I gave everybody in the family pillows, Precious Moment pillows, for Christmas that year. And when my mother opened this one, she started crying because she knew it was Dad's. And I had it. In fact, it was in this chair. I was using it as, you know, just a pillow. And because I was dumb in 1984, I was like 25 and didn't know what I was doing, when I made the pillow, I put a satin border around the stitching and then a back on it and just stuffed it. And the satin all ripped. It was all, and I sat down at my sewing machine to like see if I could fix it, and it was all just in tatters. And so I cut this part of it out and extracted a promise from my husband that someday we would get it framed. And it's all It was used. I mean, it's the fabric is kind of dirty and there are snags and stuff in it, but that's a big deal. Someday it will be framed and hanging on my wall. Let's see. What else can I tell you? Flood update. They're still here. I don't know if you can hear them. You can hear my husband's brother-in-law out there in the kitchen talking. They're still here. My father-in-law's been talking to a contractor. They've looked at flooring options and new kitchen cabinets. I was sitting in the living room one day, and my father-in-law said something about the kitchen cabinets that they could get would only be $7,000. And my mother-in-law said, "Oh, that's not bad." And I'm like, "In what universe is that not bad? I couldn't afford $7,000 in cabinets. Couldn't afford $700 in cabinets." "Oh, but if we were to get custom cabinets, okay, but $7,000 is a lot of money." And they had a big argument about flooring. My mother-in-law wanted the flooring that she had before, and she can't get that. And she actually said, "I wish there hadn't been a flood." And we're all like, "Yeah, well, we all kind of wish there hadn't been a flood, but that's the way it goes." I don't know. I don't think work has started on the house. I don't know what's going on. I don't think so. I think they're still waiting for the contractor. And the other day, my mother-in-law did say something to me about, "See, eventually, someday we'll be out of here." And I was in a bad mood that day and said, "Yeah, probably Thanksgiving." But they're still here. I don't know what's going on. Like I said, nobody tells me anything. My son is, struggling with school. It's just a thing that happens, I guess. I've been completely overstressed about everything. In fact, I think about a week ago, I had never had an anxiety attack before, but I think it happened. From what I can imagine, from what happened and what people have told me and what I've told them, it seems to me that I had an anxiety attack, and it happened like twice that day, maybe three times. And my daughter came to visit and sat down with me and said, "Oh, I can't imagine why you'd have anxiety attacks, Mom. The cat got in Noah's room and peed all over everything." My sister-in-law cleaned up everything. She took like all his bedding and all the stuff out. While we were in France, my mother-in-law let the cats out of the rec room and let them wander the house. And so you can't really tell them now they can't do that. So now every morning after Noah goes to school and Steve goes to work, and my mother-in-law gets up, she takes her cat out, one of her cats, and she just lets the cat wander around the house. The cat nibbles on the dog's food, and my poor dog just kind of stands there and goes, "But, when is she going to be done? Because that's my food." He won't push her. She won't push her. Molly won't push Tootsie or Maria. I don't remember which one it is. They have two black cats, and every time I say I saw one of them, everybody just goes, "Was it the fat one?" I'm like, "I don't know. It's the black cat. They all look the same. They look exactly the same." I mean, everybody laughs. Like, "Oh, they don't look at all like two black cats." And I put food in Molly's dish, and she was sleeping in the living room, and Tootsie, I guess it was, walks over and starts nibbling at the dog food. I'm like trying to get Molly to come and eat her food, and she stands there and looks at the cat, was like. So I pushed the cat out of the way, and then Molly came over and looked at me like, "Is it okay if I eat this? Maybe it's hers. I don't want to hurt anything. I don't want to make waves." So that's what's going on here. Same as always, just the same. In fact, my sister-in-law and her husband were saying the other day that they've completely kind of forgotten what life was like in the other house. And I said, "Oh, yay. Yeah, getting really comfortable here." In other news, I am I have been playing around with the idea of making project bags. And as you can see behind me, I have 45 tons of fabric that I always had really big plans for. And now I think I'm just going to try to make project bags and sell them. And I made one for myself that didn't turn out quite the way I wanted it to. This one is better. This is my Wizard of Oz. See? The backing is upside down, but it's right side up here. And it's got a green interior. It's not the same green, but it's green. And this was my messing with the pattern and trying to get it to be what I wanted it to be. And this is, I think, pretty close to what I want it to be. And I'm going to make a bunch more and I am going to sell them. So if you are interested in purchasing a project bag from me, I have started a group on Facebook. It's called Romance Chick Designs. I will put a link in the, excuse me, oh my goodness, excuse me, in the description below, a link to the group. It's a closed group. All you have to do is ask to join if you're interested, and I will let people know when I'm ready to put bags up. I'm gonna sort of do it the way Trisha from Three Owls was doing, where you post it, here's the price, and the first one to claim it can get it. I will let Facebook, I will let the group know when I have more than just this one. Again, it's Romance Chick Designs because I used to go, my email used to be Romance Chick because I write romance and I was trying to write chick lit at the same time. So just called myself Romance Chick, and so I use that for a lot of things. Now I'm gonna give you a little haul. I had more haul, but it's not like organized, and it's some of them are things I want to start working on. But I'm gonna show you a couple of things. These are all things that I got off Stash Unload. Okay, so this is a. Called Mermaid Heaven. Isn't that cute? I'm really into mermaids these days. It's by Saffan Boris the Pandit. I don't, I'm going to show you the name because I can't really read that. I've been really into mermaids, and so I've got fabric. I've got fabric all ready to start that at some point. I bought a few Teresa Wentzler stuff off of Stash Unload, but they're not. Again, I'm completely disorganized. There's no organization to anything. But I got the Storyteller. I think as a fantasy author, I really like that. I want to get that one stitched, and think I've got fabric for it. I want to get it stitched so I can hang it on a wall near where I write. I think that would be cool. Okay, this one, it turns out the Holy Family that I found out this. The Holy Family that I was stitching in France was by Carol L. Emmer. It was from the cross stitcher back 1980, 1990 something. And one of the things I didn't like about it was that it had Saint Joseph in half crosses in the back, and so it was sort of a ghostly figure in the background. And I found on Stash Unload two religious designs. This one's called the Newborn King, and this is called Jesus in the Garden. And I didn't realize they're both by her, and they both have half cross stitch figures. This angel is all half cross stitch stitches. And the apostles sleeping are all half cross stitches in the background. And when I saw that this one was by her and it had all the half cross stitches, then I looked up this one. I looked this one to see, and it doesn't say it on the front, but it says it on the back. Needlework adaptation by Carol Emmer. So I guess she just likes the half cross stitch stuff in the back. The next one that I got was another Leisure Arts. It's apples and pears. My husband really, really loves apples. So I'm going to do the apple one. And on that same note, I got this apple sampler. I really like that. Even without it being just about it being apples, I just like the colors of it. I think that's really pretty. And this is a Janlin. It's berries. It's a berries sampler. I showed you for the Mania Starts. I have. They were supposed to be just trays, a blueberry and then strawberries that you were supposed to put on trays, and I'm putting them together on one big piece of fabric, and I think this will kind of go with it. Now this one is a Leisure Art. These are all supposed to be done on waste canvas. It's farm animals. I got it because of the pig. Because of Pigsty Princess. I thought the pig was cute, and apparently I have a thing for pigs, especially since I wrote that book. I've developed a thing for pigs. So that's, I have lots of things I want to start. I'm supposed to be doing the year of whips, and I had also declared it for myself, year of finishes. But again, cross-stitching is supposed to be fun, and so that's what's fun for me. I started one in the carpool line today. It was it's a dragon. It's on some hand-dyed fabrics by LJ. It's called Dark Princess, and I have it in the other, it's across the room in my personal project bag, which is the same style as this one. But mine is a little shorter because I wasn't paying attention when I made it. So that's all the news. This was a very disjointed and probably boring video, but this is me. Just take it or leave it. Again, it's been, today is the 10th. In 3 days it will be 2 months since the flood, and a month and a half since my brother died. Life is life, and I have bad days and good days. Today's was not a great day, but I'm gonna go out in the living room. I'm gonna stitch and just relax. So everybody have a great stitchy day. Put in a few stitches for me. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them. Don't forget to stop by Romance Chicks Designs on Facebook and say hi, and talk to you guys later. Bye.